This lesson in quantitative aptitude is about a very important concept called permutations and combinations. This topic is important not just for the IBPS, but pretty much every competitive exam that you might give. Let us start by understanding the concept of what permutations and combinations actually are. A permutation is the number of possible arrangements of a set of objects, whereas combinations is a number of ways in which you can select some of these objects out of a group. Let's understand this with the help of an example. Let us say that you have three boxes. You have a blue box, a green box, and an orange box. There are six ways in which you can arrange these three boxes in a straight line. There are six ways in which you can arrange these three boxes in a straight line. You could arrange them in the order blue, green, orange. Blue, orange, green. Green, blue, orange. Green, orange, blue. Orange, blue, green. Or orange, green, blue. There are six different ways in which you can arrange them in a straight line. These six ways are called permutations. That is, you have six different permutations of arranging these three boxes. On the other hand, there would be a few ways in which you would select a few boxes out of these three boxes. If you had to select just one box, you could probably select a blue box or a green box or an orange box. That is, there are three ways of selecting one box out of these three boxes. If you have to select two boxes, you could either pick a blue box and a green box, or a blue box and an orange box, or an orange box and a green box. And if you had to select three boxes, there's just one way of doing it because you're selecting all three. So you see that depending on how many of the components of a group that you have to choose, the number of combinations would vary. Since a permutation is a way of listing or ordering things, the order in which you list these things or the order in which you select these things matters. On the other hand, a combination is just a group of things. So it doesn't matter how you select them. As long as they're all in the same group, they form the same combination. Therefore, in a combination, the order of selection does not matter. For example, if you pick the three boxes in the order blue, green, and orange, or you pick them as blue, orange, and green, or you pick them as green, blue, and orange. All these three are different permutations because the order of selection is different. On the other hand, all of these are the same combination because ultimately they are the same group. That is, assume you have a bag with these three boxes inside. Irrespective of how you place these three boxes into the bag, the final combination is the same. That is, you have one blue box, one green box, and one orange box. So it doesn't matter how and in what order you pick these boxes and keep it in the bag. The contents of the bag are the same. This is an important concept that you must understand. Permutations are a list and combinations are a group. In a list, the order in which things are listed matters. In a group, just the combination and content matters. The order of selection does not matter. Because irrespective of how you select, they all form the same group. There are three key concepts that you must learn when it comes to permutations and combinations. The first concept that you must understand is that of factorials. Then we shall look at the permutation formula and then the combination formula. Let us now understand the concept of a factorial. The factorial of a number is the product of that number with all the numbers that are less than it. For instance, 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 is 5 factorial. In general, n factorial is n multiplied by n minus 1 multiplied by n minus 2 and so on until 1. Let's look at the formula for calculating the number of permutations of a set of objects. Imagine you have 7 boxes numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now, out of these 7 boxes, you have to pick three boxes and arrange them in a lineup. That is, you have to select three boxes one by one out of these seven boxes and put them in a lineup. Now, there are seven ways of choosing your first box. That is, you can pick either box 1 or box 2 or box number 3, box 4, box 5, box 6 or box 7. Given seven different boxes, there are seven ways of picking one box. After you have picked the first box, there are six boxes remaining, so therefore there are six ways of choosing your second box. And there are five ways of choosing your third box. So the total number of ways in which you can select these three boxes are seven. That is seven for your first box, multiplied by six, six being the number of ways for your second box, multiplied by five, which is the number of ways of choosing a third box. So the total number of ways by which you can select three boxes one by one out of seven boxes is seven multiplied by six multiplied by five. So in general, if you have to order k people out of n people, the number of permutations that you shall have is given by this formula. Now the permutation is denoted by npk. This is the standard notation for denoting a permutation. What this means is, this is the number of permutations. What this is the number of permutations where you select k objects out of n objects. This number of permutations is equal to n factorial divided by n minus k factorial. So going back to our example of picking three boxes out of seven boxes, the number of permutations shall be given by 7p3, which shall be equal to 7 factorial divided by 7 minus 3 factorial. This is equal to 7 factorial divided by 4 factorial. Now if you remember, 7 factorial is 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 4 factorial is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. We put that in here. 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 cancels out from numerator and denominator. Therefore, this is equal to 7 into 6 into 5. Let us now understand the formula and mathematical concept behind combinations. Remember that in combinations, the order doesn't matter. Remember in the explanation of permutations, where we were picking 3 boxes out of 7. Now, a combination of 3 boxes out of 7 shall be in a similar way, just that the order of choosing those three boxes doesn't matter. So the order of choosing those boxes doesn't matter. That is, if I pick box number 3 first, then 4, then 5, or I pick 4, then 3, then 5, or I pick 5 or 4 or 3, it's all the same thing. Now we know the total number of permutations. However, when we calculated the total number of permutations, all of this were counted multiple times. So how do we account for this multiple counting? We must first find how many times this multiple counting has happened, or how many such rearrangements exist which are different permutations but the same combination. That is, in how many ways can we rearrange three boxes? So the number of ways in which you can arrange three boxes is given by the permutation. So the number of ways in which you can rearrange three boxes is 3p3, or 3 factorial, which is equal to 6. Therefore, each combination of 3 boxes has been counted 6 times. This means that for every combination of 3 boxes, there are 6 different permutations. What does this mean? This means that if we pick 3 boxes out of 7 boxes, there are 6 variations in how we choose the 3 boxes. Or for every combination of 3 boxes, there are 6 permutations. Therefore, to correct this and find the correct number of combinations, we have to divide the total number of permutations divided by the number of variations in the selected set. The total number of permutations, if you remember, was 7 into 6 into 5. And the total number of variations in how you select 3 boxes is 6. So the total number of combinations is 7 into 6 into 5 divided by 6. In general, the number of combinations when you're selecting R objects out of N objects, and it's denoted by NCR, is equal to N factorial divided by N minus R factorial into R factorial. NCR is a standard way of denoting a combination. It means the total number of combinations when R objects are grouped out of N objects. NCR is a standard way of denoting a combination. It means the number of combinations when you are grouping R objects from N objects. One thing to note is that permutations and combinations also have this alternate representation. So if you see this in a question paper, do not get confused because they mean the same thing. A permutation, that is NPK, can also be denoted as P of N, K. Similarly, a combination NCR can also be denoted as C of N, R. This is just something that you have to keep in mind because sometimes a question paper may have it denoted in a different way and you shouldn't get confused then. Let us now look at the different kinds of questions that can be asked. The first question type deals with permutations. As an example, how many 8-digit landline numbers can BSNL make such that the first two digits are 2 and 4 and no digit is repeated? Now, since these are telephone numbers, the order of the numbers is important. That is, a telephone number such as 2, 4, 5, 6, 7 is different from a telephone number 2, 4, 6, 5, 7, even though they have the same set of digits. But the order is important because a different way of listing the number results in a different telephone number. Since the order here is important, this question is a permutation question, so we shall use the permutation formula. Now this is an 8-digit telephone number and the first two digits have been fixed as 2 and 4, so there are only 6 remaining digits for us to work with. Also, the question states that no digit is repeated, so 2 and 4 cannot appear in the remaining 6 digits. Therefore, we have 8 digits to be put in 6 places. That is, we have to pick 6 numbers out of 8. Now, picking 6 digits from 8 digits is given by 8P6, which is equal to 8 factorial divided by 8 minus 6 factorial as per the permutations formula. Simplifying it further, this reduces to 20,160. That is, BSNL can make 20,160 telephone numbers with the given conditions. The second question type is for combinations. For example, an English question paper has 10 questions on antonyms. If a student has to answer 5 out of the 10 questions, how can he do that? Now the student just has to group 5 questions out of 10. The order in which the student answers these 5 questions is immaterial. Therefore, since the order is not important, this kind of question is a combination question. This is a good way for you to understand whether to use a permutation formula in a question or a combination formula. Just read the question and understand the logic. If the order of selection is important, it is a permutation question. If it is just a way of just grouping everything and the order of selection is not important, it would be a combination question. Now, this question is a combination question. The student has to answer 5 out of 10 questions. That number is given by 10C5. Now, going by the combination formula, 10C5 is equal to 10 factorial divided by 10 minus 5 factorial into 5 factorial. Reducing this further gives us the number 252. Therefore, there are 252 different groups of 5 questions each that you can form from 10 questions. Let us now look at some tips and shortcuts for solving permutation and combination problems. The first is regards to the calculation of a permutation. The formula for calculating the number of permutations requires the calculation of factorials. The calculation of factorials can take time, especially if the number is really large, because then the number of times that you have to multiply increases. So here is a useful shortcut for saving that amount of time. Now, if you have to calculate NPK, what you have to do is decrease N in steps of 1, that is, keep subtracting 1 from n, do that k minus 1 times and multiply all those numbers by n. For example, if you have to calculate 8p3, you have n is equal to 8, k is equal to 3. That gives you k minus 1 as 2. Therefore, you have to decrease 8 by 1 two times. The first would be 8 minus 1 equal to 7. The second would be 7 minus 1 equal to 6. Now you have to multiply these numbers by 8. So 8p3 shall be equal to 8 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 6, which is equal to 336. The second shortcut is for a quick way of calculating NCR. Here again, the main time-consuming factor is the calculation of factorials. One useful shortcut is to calculate NPR using the previous shortcut and divide that by R factorial. For example, 8C3 shall be equal to 8P3 divided by 3 factorial. You can calculate 8P3 using the shortcut just provided and divide it by 3 factorial. Third shortcut is also for the calculation of NCR. The shortcut formula is NCR is equal to NC of n minus r. Now this is very useful if n and r are large. So for instance, 8C3 shall be equal to 8C5 because 8 minus 3 equal to 5. Similarly, 7C4 is equal to 7C3 because 7 minus 4 equal to 3. This ends the session on permutations and combinations. Now the concepts we understood here are not just important because questions on permutations and combinations can be asked, but because these concepts shall also carry forward into the topic of probability, which shall be your next lecture.